Welcome back to Let's Play Amberstar Blind. I am the RPG chick, Amethyst Lunatari, still here in the city of Twin Lake, about to go down into the sewers to see if we can get, slaughtered? I mean, I've not done any battles, so I can't say how good my chances would be. Anyway. Somebody was telling me about the cursor keys. I don't know if they meant these keys on the screen or the arrow keys on the keyboard. Oh, I'm pressing the left twice. It did not move. There we go. So possibly they mean these keys, you know. People hated when I clicked on the screen in Dungeon Master and such to move, but yeah, that something's wrong with what do you call it? Sorry, I was looking at something. Something's wrong with what do you call it? The way the keyboard keys work, for lack of a better term. So entering the sewers. Lock cannot be opened. Okay. Apparently we need a key then. There's a key here. Oh, it's a lockpick. We shouldn't have to use a lockpick. I mean, I'm assuming picking the lock uses up the lockpick, so we might not want to do that. Maybe we need to go back to Lord Carwine and ask him for a key to the place. That'd be nice. Since he told us we could go in there and fight whatever, but didn't give us a key. Nice. Anyway, I was also thinking about the dancing dragon, which I think is down here. I'm not sure which quest is easier. I mean, this is a full-blown sewer. I mean, this could be a huge area. You know, sewers in RPG games. So, it's down here, actually. So this is just a cellar. So we might just have one enemy to face here in the Dancing Dragon. So since it's nearby, closer than Carwine. Carwine's, like, way down in this remote area. Let us go back to the Dancing Dragon to see if we can solve their problem. I imagine it's gotta be rats, right? I mean, starting dungeon, starting enemy is always rats. Alright, so gonna turn right and then head down and make a right. So I'm guessing you mean these keys. Wherever it was. Sorry. Terrible with names. Let me just check, make sure I'm headed in the right direction. Thank God for the auto map. Yep. Alright. At least I think I am. No. Then I'm headed this way. I need to turn around and make a right. Hi again. We there yet? Keep going and make a left. And is this it? Yes. Could use my map, but why the hell not? The song is so fast-paced, it sounds like battle music to me. I like the way when you walk up to a chair, you automatically sit down in it. So, now we have... I have a knife. Here's a club. Now, all I know with the combat is that it is... turn-based. And since you're using melee weapons like this, you need to... you need to be adjacent to the enemy. So you need to be either right in front of the enemy, or diagonally. I'm trying to remember where the wine cellar is now. Not close enough. Plus we're sitting down. Unexpectedly sitting down. Did I look at this? Nothing, huh? Ow. No. You may not offer me stuff. Oh, it's okay. Apparently they do not understand you. Alright. Have you talked to this person? Yeah, I believe we talked to that person. Don't mind me, guys. Just trying to find out where... I'm clicking furiously. Trying to figure out where the cellar might be. Did I check this? Just trying to be thorough here with stuff. Oops. Okay, so it's not down here. It's not down this hallway at all. Through here, perhaps? We got two people in here. Yeah, I remember talking to them too. Oh, we left. That's the way out. I think the only place we haven't gone is up through here? Is this the cook? Oh, it's the barmaid. Voluptuous barmaid. Okay, through here? If I don't find it soon, I'm gonna have to start cutting parts out, because this is really unfortunately, now I haven't played for a week or so. So I've forgotten where things are. Through here, maybe? I'm trying over here. I think I've already been in there, too. Ah! Stairs down. Oh. This item cannot be used. Well, I want to put it in his hand. Okay, we probably have to... if that didn't do anything, I'm restoring the game. Okay, good. It says it can't be used, but then I clicked on something to use it. So a new song, I like it. Oh, and here's our torch. Nice. Good indicator. Ouch. So I imagine we've got a map here as well. Now I wonder if we're real time until we get in the battle and then it's turn-based, or we're turn-based now. Breth's Wine Cellar. This goes... We came from that way? Oh, I can't believe I did that. How embarrassing. Yeah, let's go this way. Before you is a large pile of broken bottles, glasses, and mugs. In the pile of broken glass, you find an undamaged empty flask. Nice. View. Okay. Got an empty flask. Now, can we still move ahead? Looking for secrets. I'm gonna be tapping every wall. This can be really ridiculous. Okay. Go past the entrance. Large barrels of centuries-old oak are standing in the niches of this hall. Wouldn't this just automatically view it? Hmm. We got a large open space. I don't like open spaces in games like this. That's a very cheery song for a dungeon. That was very cheesy, but I don't know if I'm gonna survive stuff. This is how we save. Ta-da! Alright, so we'll go this way. Interesting. The hinges of the door before you are covered with rust. Only a crowbar can open this door. Huh. Alright. Only a crowbar can open that door. So we need a crowbar. We've got something missing there. Oh, right, right, that's where... I'll get used to this, guys. It's pretty neat. I like this little map. Okay, so we need a crowbar. We obviously don't have one. I'm pretty sure I'd remember anything like a crowbar. I predict I'm gonna end up dropping this stuff. Did I already drop this stuff? Shandra's book. This is the one that coincided with the novel. I'm pretty sure. Text scroll. Yeah. And this is the map that came with the game. So I'm going to end up dropping this stuff. Because you can't sell it. At least not to this merchant. Let's continue on here. Alright. Another thing that requires a crowbar. Oh, he went through. Alright. Ouch. I like to look at the map, guys. Don't blame me. Okay, so I can see a little something on the other side here. Can't get through, though. Interesting. It is interesting how we can see through that. Right. Oh, our torch went out! No, I saved a new game, guys. Okay, so we need more torches. That's for sure. How would we ever find our way out otherwise? She has one torch. You know, I'm wondering if there's an indicator showing when... Yeah, because how big is this place? Because once our torches go out, we only have one left. We should probably light this one torch and beat it out of here and get back to the merchant. But first, actually... use it. Yeah, I don't want to risk it. We'll go back to the merchant. Shouldn't be too far away. I think it's back this way. Back up this way. Yeah. Keep to the right. after I come out of this area. I love the music. It's awesome. We need to buy, like, quite a few torches, apparently. Well, that was interesting. Now, we can't unuse the item, right? It's just... yeah. It's just gonna burn itself out of it anyway. Right. Okay, so... yeah, I'll remember where it is this time. This is the way out, right? Okay. Now hold on, because I got a little map here of the stuff. I'm gonna pause this for a sec. Okay. The merchant is here. I don't know which way I'm facing. The right way. Okay, I need to make a right. A right. And I'm gonna come out of there a right. Run into the local store. He doesn't have torches! Wait, what do you want to sell to me? No. Okay. Staff... oh, torches? Okay. He doesn't have torches. He has 99 torches. It's not 99 left balloons. It's 99 wooden torches. View? Want to sell to me now. Oh, is this my gold? Do I have no gold? Did I screw something up? How did I do that? Did I end up dropping my gold or something? I think I might have messed something up. Cause didn't I sell a bunch of things? Eek! Now I want to go back and watch my other videos. It's gotta be the, like, the last two videos or something. Wait, he can't wear this, right? You're wrong class. We got extra clothes. So I say sell the clothes and see if we can get some torches with that. I think I messed something up. He's gonna give me 3 gold. Yeah, I might end up abandoning this. not the let's play, guys, don't worry. But, if I mess something up and... yeah, I'm gonna have to give... I don't know. And I'm no longer timing here. So... So we have 3 gold. Supposedly this is one of the pieces of the Amberstar? I don't even know. I don't have enough gold. A torch is 5. So I want to sell... What do I want to sell? What do you want to sell to me? Definitely not selling that. I'm curious. He'd give me 196 for that. And I guess we have to identify these potions. Yeah, see, these things have proved to be helpful. The buckler, the mace, the arrows, this chainmail, the studded leather. We could recruit somebody that needs some of that stuff, so... And I sold the extra robe. He won't buy Chandra's book. Empty flask. 1 gold. We don't have enough to buy 1 torch. Yeah, I think I might have screwed something up. So I will be right back. I'm gonna go check my other videos and crap, and I might have to, like replay some of this stuff. Be back. Okay, I'm back here in front of the merchants. I think I found out what I did in episode 5. I basically like to play almost that whole episode all over again. I had to map out the rest of the city the way I did. I had to talk to Carwin, and I had to talk to Chandra, I believe is the name, one more time, and get all the stuff out of that chest. Other than that, there really wasn't much else to do before I hit the merchant here. What I didn't realize is this is like a pot of your money, right? So you, from what I understand, if I'm using the correct terminology, you put your money into the pot. And this takes it out of the pot. Now, if there's any money left in here when you exit, then I believe it asks you if you want to give the merchant your money. Give them your, well, your stuff or whatever. Your items, which includes gold. So it's kind of confusing. See, right now we can't buy anything because we haven't put any money in the pot. Don't really like this aspect of the game, I don't think. Of course, we can sell things. And I found out that yes, torches do stack. So now I have the torches stacked. I pretty much did everything the same. She's holding... Well, now I have her holding all the potions. She has all the scrolls like she normally would. The spell scrolls. So we don't... I gave all my stuff to sell. To Silk. Just to keep it simple. So, the studded leather we'll keep. We will sell the leather. And I'm going to sell these regular clothes as well. So you have 62 gold here. Extra robe, 19 gold. And extra leather shoes, 3 gold. I'm pretty sure, yeah, that's all I want to sell. 84. So when we go like this, now he has 1206. If we go like this, Are you sure you want to give the merchant items which belong to you? If we clicked on the thumb here, I'm pretty sure we'd be just be giving him 1206 gold. So we'll go like this, empty the pot, exit. Now we don't get the prompt. And he has 402, she has 884, which is going to be 1206 gold. Ta-da. So that's what you have to do to sell things, which I did not know. And if it says that in the manual, I mean, I did check the manual again and didn't say anything like that. So not that I could see anyway. So now we have sold our stuff and we want to go back in. I'm going to save again. I'm back on here. Alright. I did save. Right now she's got all the money.